German Foreign Minister Heiko Maas said on January 7th that Europe won't stand on the sidelines while Iran withdraws from a landmark nuclear deal. Maas has been in touch with his British, French and US counterparts to find a way to de-escalate tensions after a US airstrike killed Iran's military commander Qassem Soleimani.
Und wir werden im Kreise der E3 heute auch darüber reden.
One of the points of discussion between us and our E3 partners will be how to respond adequately to Iran's announcement to withdraw from the Iran nuclear deal, as well as their stated intention not to uphold their obligations. We are still convinced that this nuclear deal is vital in preventing Iran from acquiring weapons of mass destruction. But we also won't stand by and shrug our shoulders while Tehran announces its withdrawal, and that is why we are meeting our E3 partners today to discuss the situation.
On January 7th, Iranian lawmakers voted to allocate a further 200 million euros to the Revolutionary Guards Quds force. Members of the Council of Guardians participated in Tuesday's parliamentary session to endorse the law given a triple urgency designation, which also formally labels the US Army and the Pentagon as terrorist entities.
In addition to the United States Central Command and Regional Forces of the United States, we also identified the Pentagon among these terrorists, as well as those giving the order to assassinate the martyred General Soleimani. According to this evaluation, the U.S. Secretary of Defense and Trump himself were also identified as terrorists, and they should be punished. The third article of today's triple urgency bill was actually the allocation of 200 million euros to reinforce the Quds forces, and it was ratified.
Funeral processions are taking place for those killed in the US drone strike. Muslim communities around the world continue protesting Soleimani's killing. People gathered outside the US embassy in New Delhi, carrying posters and cartoons of US President Donald Trump, chanting that they will avenge blood with blood. The United States said on January 6 it had no plans to pull its troops out of Iraq, despite the Iraqi parliament voting to expel American troops from the country.